You live on Avenue Q. You live on Avenue Q.
What do you do with the BA in English? What is my life going to be? 4 years of college and plenty of knowledge have earned me this useless degree. I can't pay the bills yet, 'cause I have no skills yet. The world is a big, scary place. But somehow I can't shake the feeling I might make a difference to the human race.
Morning, Brian.
Hi, Kate Monster.
How's life?
Disappointing.
Well, what's the matter?
The catering company laid me off.
I'm sorry.
I know. I mean, look at me. I'm 10 years out of college, and I always thought...
What?
It sounds stupid.
Oh, come on.
When I was little, I thought I would be...
What?
A big comedian on late night TV.
Oh?
But now I'm 32, and as you can see, I'm not...
Nope.
Oh, well. It sucks to be me.
No.
It sucks to be me.
No.
It sucks to be broken, unemployed, and turning 33. It sucks to be me.
You think your life sucks?
I think so.
Your problems aren't so bad. I'm kind of pretty and pretty damn smart.
You are.
Thanks.
Sucks to be Brian
and Kate.
To not have a job.
To not have a date.
It sucks to be me.
Leave your clothes out all over the floor, Nikki.
Well, you don't have to be so specific.
Pick up after yourself.
Nikki, Rob, can you have a minute? Can you settle something for us?
Certainly.
Whose life sucks more? Brian's or mine?
Ours. We live together.
We're close as people can get.
We've been the best of buddies
ever since the day we met.
So he knows lots of ways to make me really upset. Oh, every day is an aggravation.
Come on, that's an exaggeration.
You leave your clothes out. You put your feet on my chair.
Oh, yeah? You do such anal things like ironing your underwear.
You make that very small apartment we share. Oh, hell.
So do you. That's why I'm in hell, too.
Brian, what are you doing?
Oh, crap.
Why you all look so happy?
Because our lives suck.
Your lives suck? Am I hearing you correctly?
And we have lots of bills to pay!
me.
Hey there.
Sorry to bother you, but I'm looking for a place to live.
Why are you looking all the way out here?
Well, I started on Avenue A, but so far, everything's been out of my price range. But this neighborhood looks a lot cheaper. Oh, look, a for rent sign!
You need to talk to the superintendent. Let me get him.
Thanks!
Yo! Gary!
Coming, I'm coming!
Oh my god! It's Gary Coleman!
Yes, I am! I'm Gary Coleman from TV's Different Strokes. I made a lot of money that got stolen by my folks. Now I'm broke and I'm the butt of everyone's jokes. But I'm here, the superintendent of Avenue Q.
It sucks to be you.
You win!
It sucks to be you.
I feel better now.
Try having people stopping you to ask you.
Why don't you talk about Willis? It gets old.
It sucks to be you
on Avenue Q.
Sucks to be me
on Avenue Q.
Sucks to be you
on Avenue Q.
Sucks to be us, but not when we're together. We're together here on Avenue Q. We live on Avenue Q. Our friends do too. Till our dreams come true, we live on Avenue Q.
This is real life.
We live on Avenue Q.
You're gonna love it.
We live on Avenue Q.
Here's your keys.
Welcome to Avenue Q.
So, what's your name?
I'm Princeton.
Hey man, I'm Brian. And this is my fiancé.
Hi, my name is Christmas Eve. You're so cute. Very handsome. Are you single?
Yeah.
Because she's single.
Oh, Christmas Eve!
That's Kate Monster. She lives in our building.
Hi.
Hi.
Shrekkie!
No, no, no! Go away! Me busy now!
Good morning, Shrekkie. That's Shrekkie Monster.
He has antisocial personality disorder. You don't go talking with him. He wants sketchy dude.
Come on inside, kid. I'll show you the place.
Great!
You know, many distinguished people have expressed their interest in this fine address.
No kidding.
Mm-hmm.
So, what do you think, Kate Monster? He's cute, right?
Yeah.
You go get him. A man respond to an aggressive woman. You, go get job!
I'll get right on it.
See?
An afternoon alone with my favorite book, Broadway Musicals of the 1940s. No roommate to bother me. How could it get any better than this?
Oh, hi, Rod.
Hi, Nikki.
Oh, hey, Rod. You'll never guess what happened to me on the subway this morning. This guy was smiling at me and talking to me.
That's very interesting.
Mm-hmm. He was being real friendly. And, you know, I think he was coming on to me. I think he might have thought I was gay.
So why are you telling me this? Why should I care? I don't care. What'd you have for lunch today?
Oh, Rod, there's no need to get defensive.
I'm not getting defensive! What do I care about some gay guy you met, okay? I am trying to read.
Well, I didn't mean anything by it, Rod. I just think it's something we should be able to talk about.
Well, I don't want to talk about it, Nikki. It's a conversation. It's over.
Well, yeah, but Rod...
Over!
Okay, but just so you know, if you were gay, I mean, 'cause hey, I'd like you anyway. Because you see, if it were me, I would feel free to say that I was gay, but I'm not gay.
Nikki, please, I am trying to read.
What?
If you were queer, I'd still be here.
Nikki, I am trying to read this book.
Year after year.
Gay.
Because you're dear.
Ah!
And I know that you.
What?
Would accept me too.
I would?
If I told you today.
Hey, guess what?
I'm gay, but I'm not gay. I'm happy. just being with you.
High button shoes, pal Joey.
So what should it matter to me what you do in bed with guys?
Nikki, that's gross!
No, it's not. If you are gay, I shout, hooray!
I am not listening.
And here I stay.
La 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 la.
But I wouldn't pet in your way.
Ah!
You can count on me.
Job tomorrow.
Gary Coleman, it's for you.
Hello? Oh, it's my job. Hi, I can't wait to meet all of you tomorrow. But did you say downsizing? But how can I be laid off when I haven't even started yet? Wait, no, please don't hang up. Please? How am I supposed to live? Hello?
Okay, don't look so long at the face. You know what they say. If you rearrange the letters in the word unemployed, it spells opportunity.
What?
Here's a bit of advice. Never underestimate the power of long-range planning. If life gets you down, just sit on your butt and let it pass you by. Take it from someone who learned it the hard way. Gary Coleman.
Maybe this is an opportunity. Maybe I'm not supposed to work in some dumb office for the rest of my life. Maybe I have a higher purpose.
What's a purpose?
A purpose is direction to your left.
It could be a job.
A family. It could be the pursuit of knowledge or wealth.
Everybody's purpose is different.
The best thing about purpose is that it gives your life meaning.
I want a purpose.
Purpose. It's that little flame that lights a fire under your ass. Purpose. It keeps you going strong, like a car with a full tank of gas. Everyone else has a purpose, so what's mine? Oh look! Here's a penny! It's from the year I was born! It's a sign. I don't know how I know, but I'm gonna find my purpose. I don't know where I'm gonna look, but I'm gonna find my purpose. Gotta find out, don't wanna wait. Got to make sure that my life will be great. Gotta find my purpose before it's too late.
He's gonna find his purpose.
Purpose.
people laugh and make money doing it.
My purpose in life was to make people laugh, but now I just want to leave the room with a little bit of dignity.
Oh, hi, Kate.
Princeton, hi.
Say, Kate, can I ask you a question?
Oh, well, sure.
What's your purpose?
Oh, well, I'm a kindergarten teaching assistant.
Yeah, but what's your purpose, your mission, your dream?
Oh, well, nobody ever wants to know that.
I do.
Well, okay, since you asked... No, I can't. I barely know you.
Oh, come on.
Okay. When I was a little monster, I always wished I had someplace special I could go. A special school, only for monsters. The media only talks about all the bad things that monsters do. But some of the most productive members of our society are people of fur. So my dream is to start a special school only for monsters, where little monsters can become a part of the global community. So that, in short, is my purpose. But don't worry. I'm not an egghead or anything like that. I like to have fun and party, too.
Cool.
Yeah. I'll see you later, Princeton.
Okay. Bye.
Bye.
Today, I feel I'm getting closer to my purpose.
School crossing guard.
No, that's not me.
Manicurist.
Not quite it.
Birthday party clown.
Closer, but still no. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. I can see it in the corner of my mind. My purpose. It's...
Hey, Princeton!
It's us!
Who are you?
The Bad Idea Bears!
We're your friends.
Where are you going?
I'm almost broke, so I'm gonna get a job while I look for my purpose.
Well, did the check come in from your folks?
Yeah.
Then you have plenty of money.
You should celebrate!
You need to do something for you. Buy some beer!
Yeah, buy some beer!
Gee, I shouldn't be spending my parents' money on beer.
Oh. Okay.
That makes me sad. Thinking about you not having any fun.
Oh, I'm gonna cry.
Gosh, I'm sad. Some days I wish I was dead. I am.
Well, I could afford a six pack.
Yay! How about a case?
A case of beer.
No, I can't get a case.
But you're on a budget.
You're wasting your money in the long run if you don't buy in bulk.
You're right! Thanks, guys, I'll get a case!
Yay! See you around, Princeton!
See you later, guys! Gosh, they're awfully cute. It's good to know I'm making friends who have my best interest at heart.
Friends and me do buy.
sorry. Me no mean to. Okay, Monster, how come you no accept me friend request?
Could you please be quiet for 1 minute so I can finish?
Okie dokie.
Good. A friend is something you can make for free.
Online. Oops.
All you need's compatibility.
Online. Oops.
We built up a great report.
On.
'Cause that's what friends are for. And soon you'll network more and more and more.
Online.
Tricky.
Social life is online.
Tricky.
Social life is online. We have 5,600,000 friends online.
Tricky monster.
Really, King, how come you no friendly?
Because I have no use for social networking sites. I only spend time with real people. Unlike some computer crazy, socially stunted, stay-at-home monsters I could name.
You hurt me feelings, Kate Monster.
Oh, I just want you to make some real friends.
You mean real friend?
I guess so.
Then friend me!
All right, fine. How do I sign up?
Okay, go to computer. Okay. First, give name to social networking company. Then give birthday and all other personal information to social networking company. Then give pictures of you, likes, dislikes, and shopping preferences to social networking company.
I did it!
Yeah! 5,600,001 friends!
Wow!
Social life is online.
Everyone's on here!
Social life is online. Make friends quick, yeah. Just point and
Grade
click.
School? High
friends.
School?
I got your wedding invitation.
Are you coming?
Here's my RSVP.
Honey, what's all this about us getting married?
Think of it like a surprise party.
Cool.
I think it's wonderful that you have someone so special in your life.
Are you all right, Rod?
Christmas Eve, you're a therapist, right?
Yes, I have 2 massive degrees.
So you help people who have all kinds of problems?
Yes, but nobody wants to come to me for helping. We set up an appointment, we talk for an hour, and then they go and never come back. And I wonder, why?
Well,
am I fixing them in one appointment? Maybe I'm too efficient. Maybe I should spread out my help. Right, Rod, you need some help.
Well, I have this friend.
Nikki?
No, another friend. And I think he has a very big problem. I think my friend is gay.
What's wrong with that? You know, Rod, gay people make major contribution to art and literature and philosophy for many hundreds of years now.
But he's not an artist. He's a Republican. And an investment banker.
Oh. Ew. Well, tell him to stay in the closet then. He's good for nothing.
Oh, great. Thanks for the advice.
Yeah, I wouldn't like to have a friend like that.
Thanks again.
Bye now.
Bye-bye. Crap.
Princeton.
I was going through my CDs yesterday, and I kept hearing those songs I thought you would like. So, I'm into this tea.
Oh, Princeton! That's so sweet! Can I get you a drink or a snack or...
Actually, do you mind if I use your bathroom?
Oh, sure. Go right ahead.
Oh, thank you.
A mixtape. He made a mixtape. He was thinking of me, which shows he cares. Sometimes when someone has a crush on you, they'll make you a mixtape to give you a clue.
Singer at the Around the Clock Cafe. Do you wanna go with me?
Like a date?
Sure, a date. It'll be a blast.
I'd love to come.
Okay, well, I'll see you then.
Okay.
Okay, bye.
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 He likes me.
Gentlemen, I now present the comic stylings of the funniest person I know, me. I am not wearing underwear today. No, I'm not wearing underwear today. Not that you probably care much about my underwear. Still, nonetheless, I gotta say. For now, but don't move a muscle, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be right back with our headline performer.
Say, Trekkie, you never leave your apartment. What made you drag your furry butt out here?
Me see pictures of next singer on internet. Now she very, very good friend of mine.
Oh, there's an empty table.
Oh, well, let's grab it.
Ladies first.
Oh, Princeton, you're such a gentleman.
You too. I mean, you look like a knockout tonight.
Oh, you.
And now, the woman you've all been waiting for,
the Around the Clock is proud to present, fresh from her world tour, headlining in Amsterdam, Bangkok, and Celebration, Florida, the star of Girls Gone Wild, parts 2, 5, and 7, the one and only Lucy!
I can make you feel special when it sucks to be you. Let me make you feel special for an hour or two. Your life's a routine that repeats each day, and no one cares who you are or what you say, and sometimes you feel like nobody, but you can feel like somebody.
She's really something, isn't she?
She's something.
Can I get you a drink, Kate?
Oh, well, I'll just have a water. I have to be chipper to teach tomorrow. The teacher I assist for, she's going in for heart replacement surgery in the morning, and I get the whole class all to myself. Oh, and if things go well, it can mean a big boost for my career.
Hey, guys! We brought you some Long Island iced teas.
Wow, you guys are so adorable. But who are you?
We're your friends. Have a drink, Kate.
Oh no, I can't.
Just a little, it'll sip.
I really shouldn't.
But it's only a Long Island iced tea. They're so sweet and delicious. Please. Please.
All right, one sip can't hurt. Cheers, Princeton.
Cheers. Here's to you, Kate.
Yay!
Mmm, that's nummy.
Another round!
I should go powder my nose.
Great.
I'll be right back.
And this time, Kate, let's get larges.
Okay.
Hey, how's the date going, huh?
Pretty well, I think.
Now hold on there, little man. You're gonna get lucky tonight if you keep working at it.
Keep your eye on the prize.
Oh, wow! Look who's coming!
What's up?
Hi, I'm Princeton.
Lucy, man of my beat. I still haven't figured out where I'm going to crash tonight. Princeton, the drinks will be right over! Hi. I'll have a scotch on the rocks. Not the waitress!
Lucy, I'd like to meet Kate Monster.
Oh, you're dating a monster? I dated a monster once, but I got sick of getting all that fur on my clothes. Well, I'm surprised to hear that you are wearing any clothes at all.
Hey! Hey! It was nice talking to you, Lucy.
Have fun with your monster. But when you're ready for a real woman, you know where to find me.
Oh man, Kate, I'm sorry.
Princeton, it's all right. You're just irresistible is all.
Oh, well, she just knows she can't compare to you.
Princeton, I have so much fun with you.
Now's your chance. Kiss her.
Slip her the tag.
Would you guys cut that out? Kate?
Yeah?
I think you look beautiful tonight.
Oh, well, Princeton, I think you look so handsome. I could just eat you alive.
More drinks!
More fun!
Yay!
Sure can get lonely at night. Nikki, are you awake?
Is that a unicorn?
He's talking in his sleep again.
Who painted the kitten? I can put on the purple shoes.
Maybe I should just shake him.
I love you, Rod.
What did you say?
I love your little laugh.
Nikki, are you awake?
Flex your muscles.
Oh, Nicholas. Have we been hiding from each other all this time? I wonder. All those nights I laid in bed, thoughts of you running through my head.
Who put my earmuffs on the cookie?
But I never thought the things in my head could really happen in my bed.
Oh, you look like David Hasselhoff.
All the years I missed the signs, couldn't read between the lines. Who'd have thought I'd see the day where I'd hear you say what I heard you say. And now I find what was always in my mind was in your mind too. Who knew?
Such a great time tonight.
Me too, Princeton.
Listen, I want you to have this. It's a penny I carry around with me for good luck. It's from the year I was born. See? Who knows? Maybe it'll bring you good luck. It did for me. I found you. I want you to know the time that we've spent, how great it's been, how much it's meant.
I don't know what to say. I'm really glad to feel that way. Cause I'm afraid that I like you more than I've ever liked any guy before.
Cause now I'm getting what I've always been dreaming of. So are you.
Always.
were talking in your sleep.
No, I just came to bed. You were dreaming is all.
Oh.
Well, it sounded like a pretty nice dream, though.
Yes, it was a nice dream.
Okay, well, good night.
Good night, Nikki. Brian and Christmas's wedding.
Oh, of course.
Well, I was thinking we can go, maybe, you know, together.
Oh my God. Well, I feel like I always go to weddings alone. I don't really know what I would do if I went with
With a boyfriend?
Yeah.
Then come with me.
I'd love to.
Are you okay, Kate?
I'm all right. I just get fur in my eyes sometimes. That's all.
Pronounce you as a former child celebrity, husband and wife.
Mazel tov!
Gee, that sure was beautiful, wasn't it, Rod?
They're so lucky to have each other. Gee.
Oh, are you upset, Rod?
I need to be by myself.
No, Rod, talk to me. What's the matter?
Hey, Gary. What's up with Rod?
He's sure looking down at the dumps lately.
He's lonely. He need a girlfriend.
A girlfriend? You gotta be kidding me. Rod?
He's not so ugly.
Yeah, but I always figured Rod was one of those gays.
Rod? Is gay?
I bet Nikki would know.
Yo, Nick! Yo,
short guys. What's up?
We were wondering if Rod is a gay.
Oh, it's funny you ask, because I do think Rod is gay. In fact, I always have. But I thought if he wanted to tell me, he would. So, yes, definitely. I would say my buddy Rod is a closeted homosexual.
Nikki? How can you say that about me?
Oh, hi, Rod. All I said was, yes, definitely. My buddy Rod has an undescended testicle.
No, I heard you.
Oh, gee. I'm sorry, Rod.
Well, I'm not a closeted homo whatever. I have a whole life that none of you know about. Not even you, Nikki.
Well, yeah, but Rod, I'd still be your buddy even if you were gay.
Nikki, I want you out of the apartment when I get back.
You're kicking me out?
Go live in a garbage can for all I care.
Oh, gee. I'd better go see if I can patch things up with Rod. I didn't mean to make him mad on purpose.
Oh, yes. Kate Monster, I'm throwing the bouquet in a couple of minutes. I have a good eye and a husband for you.
Oh, Christmas Eve.
I might throw it to you on purpose.
Purpose.
Princeton, I had so much fun with you yesterday.
Me too.
So, what are you doing tomorrow?
Gosh, it feels like I'm forgetting something.
Wait, hold on. They're about to throw the bouquet. I'll be right back, Princeton.
Purpose. Huh. Purpose. Yeah.
Oh, what's the matter?
Kate, there's something I need to say.
Oh, well, you could tell me anything.
Listen, when I moved here to Avenue Q, I was looking for my purpose.
I remember.
And we've been spending so much time together, I've lost track of finding it.
Oh.
I don't want to be an old man and look back and realize I never found my reason to be alive.
So, you're saying that you don't want to spend time with me anymore?
No, I love being with you.
Oh, okay, good. Because I thought that
but
you were trying to say that you...
I don't want a girlfriend until I figure out my mission in life.
But you...
Kate, if we stay together now, we won't even be friends in the end.
But, Princeton, I don't want any friends. I have plenty of friends.
Well, you like me, don't you?
I do have feelings for you. And that's why I think you should get out of here.
You mean I should leave?
Unless you have another definition of get out of here.
There's a fine, fine line between a lover and a friend. There's a fine, fine line between reality and pretend. And you never know till you reach the top if it was worth the uphill climb. There's a fine, fine
of time. between together and not. And there's a fine, fine line between what you wanted and what you got.
To be me, it sucks to be single, unemployed, and almost, God, I'm old, 23, it sucks to be me.
Hey, Princeton!
We're here to cheer you up.
Oh, no.
Gosh, you look so blue.
How about a little smile?
I think I see a smile. I think I see a little smile. Aw, come on, Princeton.
Sorry, guys, it's not gonna work.
Judge Judy's your friend?
Yeah! What's Judge Judy when you feel all sad and alone?
It's not working.
Aw.
Would you guys go away?
Gosh, he's Snappy the Turtle today.
Aw, man.
Princeton!
Yeah?
Listen, man. No one's seen you for 2 weeks. Where have you been?
I got a job working at a temp agency, and they fired me for being too depressing on the phone. I maxed out my cards. I'm 2 months behind on rent. I totally messed up my personal life. And Brian, I still haven't found my purpose.
Man, you need a change of perspective. Come on, come out with me, and let's go mess around the city a bit.
No thanks.
I said, come on, Princeton. Get off your butt and let's mess around the city a bit.
There is light outside your apartment. I know it's hard to kind of see. But there's light outside your apartment. And you're only gonna see it if you leave. There are fun things to do, but they can't come to you. So come on, let's go out and explore. There is life outside your apartment. But you've got to open the door. There's life outside your apartment. There's a pigeon squashed on the street. There's a girl passing by.
No, I think it's a guy.
And a homeless man who only wants to buy something to eat. Sorry, can't help you. We could go to the zoo.
Pick up girls and buy you.
There is life outside your apartment.
Well, I guess I'll give it a shot.
There is life outside your apartment. I know it's... Ouch! There is life outside your apartment.
Don't
do it!
Okay.
There are fun things to do, but they can't come to you, so come on. There is life outside your apartment. Oh, you never know what's around the bend. You can win the lotto or make a friend. Take her home to see your apartment.
Do you want to feel special?
Special.
If you let me feel you too.
a car.
You'll be fine, then you see her.
Hope you don't get gonorrhea.
There is life outside your apartment.
But now it's time to go.
I haven't seen you around.
Uh-huh.
You gonna show me upstairs?
Sure, Lucy. One second, okay?
Sure, baby. Don't let my motor idle too long. So, is he a friend of yours?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Is her name Purpose?
Listen, Kate, I gotta go.
Have fun.
What's wrong, Kate Monster?
I hate Princeton. He's with that Lucy.
Ooh, that evil girl? She's skanky. But that don't make Princeton a bad person.
I don't know anymore.
Well, people need time to grow. People always learning all their lives. Look at Mama Bird. Once Mama throws baby at a nest, that's it. If baby bird fly, good for baby. But if baby bird fall and crack head on ground and get eaten by a cat, then they need to do better next time.
Christmas Eve? Why can't people get along and love each other?
You think getting along same as loving? Sometimes love is what you hate the most, Kate Monster. You love someone, the more you want to kill him.
Ah.
The more you love someone, the more he make you cry. Though you are trying to make peace with him and loving. That's why you love so strong, you want to.
Preston. It was good to see you yesterday. I'm really sorry about what happened, but I'd love to still do friend things with you. I'm going to visit the viewing platform at the Empire State Building tonight at midnight. Could you meet me there? If not, please call and let me know. Otherwise, I guess I'll see you there. Yours, Kate Monster. Yeah?
Oh, it's you.
Are you the cleaning lady? I will not rise to your bait. Where's Princeton?
He's in the shower. You need something?
I just wanted to give him this note. That's all.
Oh, man. I look gorgeous today. Hey, baby, you see my fantastic tan line?
Oh, so you call that a tan line? I thought it was the edge of my gigantic hickey.
Hey, kid, you almost done in there?
Yeah, I'm drying off.
He doesn't need to be messing with some monster.
Oh, hey, Brian. Listen, it's been a hard few weeks for me, what with Rod kicking me out and all, and I just wanted to thank you and your lovely bride for letting me stay with you.
Actually, I want to talk with you about that.
Brian, you tell him to go right now!
Honey, give me a second.
I don't do your housework. I don't cook for you or clean for you or pick up all of your messing. One lazy fat ass putting up for this lady. This morning, I was taking a shower and I pick up the soap and I wonder out loud, who putting little green nose hairs on the soap? They don't belong to me. They don't belong to Brian. Then who can it be from? I was about to puking. The welcome wagon, go away. It's gone.
Sorry, buddy.
Where am I supposed to go?
I mean, you could try to stay with Princeton, or maybe Kate.
But I did that already. They kicked me out, too.
Listen, man, I can't help you. I'm sorry.
Oh, hey, Gary.
Nikki.
Say, listen, Gary, I need a place to stay, and I was wondering if I could sleep on your floor or something for a couple of weeks, just until Rod and I patch things up.
Hmm. I see. Well, how do I put this? No.
No? But I've asked everyone, and if I can't stay with you, where am I going to live?
How about on the street?
You mean I should be homeless?
Sure.
But that's a terrible way to live.
Oh, yeah? Try being a has-been at age 15. Look, kid, I know from living in the dumps. But think on the bright side. Think of all the joy you'll bring to others when they find out just how miserable you are.
What?
Right now you are down and out and feeling really crappy.
I'll say.
And when I see how sad you are, it sort of makes me happy.
Happy?
Being on an elevator when somebody shouts. EUTE.
And the men I've dated. Princeton gave me this penny once. He said that it was the symbol of all of his hopes and dreams. But he never called. And I don't see him anywhere. Pretty soon, he's gonna be a whole hour late.
Hey, Lucy! Where'd you run off to this morning? I've been looking all over for you.
Oh, man. Why do I always get the clingy guys?
Clingy? You left this morning without even saying goodbye.
Look, kid. Sorry to be honest, but look at me. I can have my pick of the litter. If I want a relationship, I'll find a guy who has a good job and a future and a ton of money. And not some cute-butted baby-faced kid who leeches from his parents and can't get his act together.
I think I heard a compliment in there somewhere.
So, this is what it feels like to be stood up. I'm gonna get rid of this stupid penny. And I'm gonna make a wish, too. I wish, more than anything in the world, that I find someone who I love and who loves me back. Yay! Somehow, I still don't feel any better.
But I'm only waiting for my purpose, Lucy. My break, my big revelation.
You know the only revelation people have in life, kiddo? They're not special. You're not special. You're no luckier or more gifted than anyone else.
You don't think so?
No.
Now whenever I pass by this place, I'll think of what you said just now.
What's so special about this place?
You mean right here on 34th and 5th, right next to the Empire State Building?
Oh, no.
Lucy!
Princeton, I heard your friend had an accident. Is she okay?
Her head fell off in the ambulance. The doctor spent all night sewing it back on, but the prognosis is good.
Oh my God! What happened to her?
Some idiot threw a penny at the Empire State Building.
What a shame!
What are you doing here?
You never called.
Huh?
In the note that I left you.
What note?
The note that I left with... Oh, I feel better now.
So, how you feeling, Kate?
Honestly?
Of course.
Terrible. I work at Barnes & Noble. I miss my students. I work all day, and I'm poorer than ever.
Well, what about your monster school?
Oh, Princeton, some people's dreams come true. I'm just not one of those people.
Don't say that.
But Princeton, that's the way that life is. They don't teach you that when you're a kid. Because if they did, you'd never dream or want to grow up. But we never stop growing up. I'm late for work.
Kate, I wish you were happy. I wish I had it together, but I don't. And I'm not sure when that's going to happen. I'm sorry for hurting your feelings, because I think you're so special. I'm sorry that wasn't more articulate.
No, it was perfectly articulate. But I really gotta go.
Help the homeless? Help the homeless? Help the homeless? Help the homeless? Oh, hey, Broad.
Is that wind I hear rustling through the branches?
No, it's your old buddy, Nikki. Oh, I see. Listen, Rod, from now on, I'll believe anything you say about yourself. And I'm sorry for being such a messy roommate. Now that I have a place of my own, behind that dumpster over there.
I can appreciate how hard it is to keep things neat. Rod, can you hear me?
You okay, Rod?
Christmas Eve. Can I consult with you briefly?
Sure. Come here. What's their problem today?
It's tiny, really.
Go on.
I look at all my old friends who are married, and I look at you and Brian, and I wonder, how come I don't have anybody by my side? Someone who makes me feel special and safe. Someone who loves me the way I love them. Christmas Eve!
Rod, look at me. You're special. Rod, you're safe.
I miss Nikki.
I know you do. Come here.
I wish I could go back to college. Life was so simple back then.
I knew to go back and live in a dorm with a meal plan again.
I wish I could go back to college. In college, you know. And think, oh my God, I am totally gonna go far.
How do I go back to college? I don't know who I am anymore.
I wanna go back to my room and find a message and try a erase pen on the door.
You seem all down in the dumps.
You could say that.
Yeah, I've been down in the dumps lately, too. Living there, in fact. Say, could you do me a favor, buddy?
Like what?
Give me a quarter.
Not right now, Nikki.
Oh, come on, Princeton. You know you want to.
I need a moment by myself.
Yeah. You know what? You need to stop thinking about yourself all the time. Try doing something for someone else for a change. Like me. Come on, Princeton. Give me a quarter. Here in my hat, you'll feel better. It's easy as that. Helping others brings you closer to God. So give me a quarter.
I don't have any change.
Okay, give me a dollar.
That's not what I meant.
Five.
Are you kidding?
The more you give, the more you get. That's being alive. All I'm asking you is to do what Jesus Christ would do. He'd give me a quarter. Why don't you
Alright, alright. Here you go.
Aw, thanks.
Take care.
Bye.
Whoa!
Oh, what's the matter?
I feel generous. I feel compassionate.
Hey, if you give me a 20, you'll feel even better.
I feel like a new person. A good person. Helping other people out makes you feel fantastic. All this time I've been running around, thinking about me, me, me. And where has it gotten me? I'm gonna do something for someone else.
Oh, me?
No! Kate! I'm gonna raise the money to build that stupid monster school she's always talking about.
Okay.
So what a burger!
When her dream comes true, it will all be partly thanks to you. So give me your money.
I'd like to, but I can't.
Give me your money.
I'd like to, but I need it.
Give me your money.
I'd like to, but I'm homeless. I can't. I need it. I'm homeless. I can't. I need it. I'm homeless. I can't. I need it. I'm homeless. I can't. Ow!
Okay. Here you go.
Thanks!
Suddenly, I am feeling closer to God. It's time to stop begging. It's time to start giving. What can I give to Rod? Something he'll like so much, he'll take me back. I know, I'll find him a boyfriend.
That's the spirit.
When you help others, you can't help helping yourself.
I don't know how to thank you guys. This kind of money is such a great start.
Let me check. $6.
$6? Is that all we got?
Looks like we're going to have to ask more people.
Give us your money. All that you got. Just work it on over.
Pockets will get shot.
Hey!
It's time to pass the hat.
School for monsters.
What'd you say?
Kate, she wants to build a school for monsters.
School? For monsters? Me never hear of that. I really never heard of that.
School for monsters. School for lonely little monsters. When me little going to school, other children think me not cool, poking and pulling at me fur. now me have therapist and work on this with her. But me no need therapy if Monster School a reality. Me be right back. Me give you $10 million!
Tricky! Where'd you get all that money?
Me sell all me friends' personal information to marketing companies!
When you help others, you can't help helping yourself.
In too.
Guys, I don't even know what to say.
Just say thanks.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you all. The entire Monster community thanks you.
And now that everyone's gathered here, Christmas Eve and I, we also have an announcement.
We're getting divorced!
What?
I'm only kidding. I'm only kidding. But we are leaving Avenue Q.
What?
We married now. It is time to move on to a nicer neighborhood. To Flushing.
But you guys can't leave.
Aw, we'll keep in touch. And there's another reason as well. I'm starting a new career.
Oh, that's great.
Yes, I'm a consultant.
I'm not knowing what that is, but I'm so proud of him. And I have news too. I finally have regular paying client. I am now a paid therapist.
Well, who's the client?
Ooh, I'm not allowed to say, but we're meeting 7 times a week at $125 an hour. He need a lot of help. But at the end of the road, he going to come out as integrated person.
I bet I know who it is.
He much better now.
Oh, you mean Rod.
I'm not allowed to say.
Hey, speaking of Rod, where is he anyway? Get him out here.
Oh my god!
Crap! Champagne for everybody. Oh. I've got news.
Rod, you're okay.
And you're okay. Listen, everybody, I faced my fears and won. And there's a few things I'd like to say. Number one, I'm sorry for being so hot-headed and difficult all the time. And it was because, and this is number two, hold your applause, everybody. I, Rod, am gay. Oh, hey. And number three, Nikki, I'm sorry. You're my best friend, and I've missed you so much. Will you move back in with me?
If it'll make you happy.
It would.
Hooray!
Oh, Nikki.
Oh, and Rod, guess what I did for you? I put a personal ad all over the internet with your picture on it.
You did what?
And I found you someone very special.
Rod, no, you know, I'm leaving.
It's okay. Just breathe, okay?
Rod, meet Ricky.
Nikki? And Ricky? Do you like Broadway musicals and knitting and Parcheesi?
Do I ever?
Great. Then you're my boyfriend. Let's go.
Everybody's dreams are coming true. And then there's Gary Coleman.
Come on, Gary.
Yeah. You've still got all of us.
Well, since you two are leaving, I guess I better put that darn for rent sign back up.
Wow. The Montessori School.
Oh, yeah. gay monster. You know who get idea to raise money and build school for you?
Oh, Christmas Eve. Was it you?
No, it was Princeton.
You said you couldn't make your dreams come true by yourself. So I shot for the stars.
You gotta go after the things you want while you're still in your prime.
There's a fine, fine line between love. Thank you, Princeton.
So, will you take me back, Kate?
Oh, well, I don't know. I'll be so busy with all the contractors and hiring teachers and picking textbooks and...
I can help you.
Just take it one day at a time.
So, I'd like to ask about apartments for rent. Wait a minute. That's it!
What?
My purpose! Look at this kid here, all fresh-faced and new and not knowing anything. He has no idea what he's in for. He thinks the hard part's over, but it's not! And maybe he needs a little help. And maybe my purpose is to take everything I've been learning and put it into a show!
You tripping?
Yeah, and I'm not some young kid who doesn't know anything. Bite me! Why does everything have to be so hard?
Maybe you'll never find your purpose. Lots of people don't.
But then, I don't even know why I'm alive.
Who dies? Everyone's a little bit unsatisfied.
Everyone goes round.
Problems of all shapes and sizes.
You're going to have to make a few compromises for now.
For now. But only for now. Only for now. Only for now. Only for now.
Hey, everybody. I had to beat it from Bible study to make it to the final number.
Lucy, is that you?
A whole new me. That penny took out half my brain, but it only took out the mean stuff.
And we reformed our ways too.
We found Scientology!
Yay!
For now we're healthy.
For now we're employed.
For now,
but only for now, only for now.
is only for now.